Welcome to Ayuchintana. As the sun spreads its refulgent rays in daytime and enlightens the place full of darkness, making it bright, in the same way, the skilled physician destroys the diseases of patient fastly by making free from the clutches of a disease. Thus, the patient is relieved from disease by an expert of Ayurveda, a Bhishak or a Suvaidya. With this background, Ayuchintana aims to find the narrative technique of systematic writing sequence of this Ayurveda Samhita. To realize its specific nature, one must study and practice at the same time. Thus, we shall realize how practically Tantra has been written. This is the series on Jataragni Chintana, Episode 2. Today, let's discuss how Hita Ahara as a Nitya Rasayana dependent on Agni Sandukshana. Taking a quick recap of first episode leaves us with an understanding of what is Agni Sandukshana, why Agni Sandukshana is essential, how to cause Agni Sandukshana, how to select Hitatama Ahara Dravya. We understood the importance of Ashta Ahara Vidhi Visheshayatana in the first episode. Also, Agni Udirana is caused by Ushna, Snigdha, Matra Ashana and Jirne Ashana. Tejav Patha indicates the Agni Vahasrotis, and this was one important discovery. Lina Dosha being the reason for Avarana to Tejav Patha. Each factor in Ahara Vidhividhana are interlinked and shall not be omitted. Hence, Jirne Ashniyat is the common Chikitsa principle for all the variety of diseases and mainly Santarpanajanya Vyadhis. With Jiva Utpatti, Agni Utpatti occurs. For sustenance of Agni, Ahara Rupi Indhana has to be served at every mealtime, and finally, with diminution of Agni, life comes to an end. Hence, Ahara is of prime importance for maintenance of optimum Agni. This is why exactly Acharya Charaka signifies Hita Ahara to be consumed just like Rasayana. Is Ahara a Nitya Rasayana? The benefit of consuming Rasayanas is to impart rejuvenating action to Rasadi Dhatus. But what is Rasayanam? Ayanam means Griham, home. Patham or Margam means path. But also, Srotis has a synonym called Rasayanyaha and also Rasavahinyaha. What are their actions? Srotamsi parinamam apadyamananam dhatunam abhivahini bhavanti ayanarthena. Srotis are pathways or a platform for the passage or movement of transforming dhatus, as explained in Charaka Vimana 5. Thus, even Rasayanyaha and Rasavahinyaha turns out to be the pathways for effective transformation and transportation of dhatus. Rasayanas are those which are beneficial to the path of every dhatu, starting from Rasadhatu. Acharya Charaka in Vimanasthana gives us a guideline as follows. Aharascha viharascha yahasya doshagunaihi samaha dhatubir vigunaschapi srotasam sapradushakaha. This shloka explains that ahara and vihara are two roots or main reasons through which samasthiti or dushti of srotas or rasayanis can occur. Hence, if ahara is consumed properly, it becomes a rasayana and provides for the rasayanyaha, that is the srotas. One more meaning is that if ahara and vihara are not consumed appropriately, they definitely alter or cause imbalance in doshas. So the question here is, are srotas affected by doshas or they affect the doshas? Let's understand the Bilogatya Sutra. Tesham prakopat sthanasthaschaiva margagascha shariradhatavaha prakopam apatyante. Itaresham prakopat itaranicha. Tesham prakopat mean doshanam prakopat. Sthanasthahacha mean one of the doshagati, that is, sthana, kshaya, vriddhi are three gatis. Please refer back to Charaka Sutra 11 and Charaka Sutra 18 to get the concept clarity. So here, one of the dosha gatis, that is sthana, if this is altered, it brings major change in dhatus. Also, margagascha mean dhatuvaha or doshavaha srotas, where marga is the synonym for srotas. Alters the nature of dhatus and cause prakopa. With this prakopa, be limited to one dhatu or its srotas, or can involve more dhatus and their respective srotas. Acharya himself clarifies here, srotamsi srotamsyeva dhatavascha dhatu neva pradushayanti pradushtaha. Meaning, previously hampered srotas can affect the other subsequent srotas. Also, already hampered dhatu can alter the normalcy of further dhatu, all because of dosha prakopa, which in turn is caused by the ahita ahara and ahita vihara. Thus, we can surely say that it is only the nature of doshas to cause dushana and not any other entity. Aren't you curious to know as to when hita ahara attains the state of rasayana? Let's explore further. Firstly, what is ahara? Ahara is that which is panchabhautika of four kinds, peya, leha, bhojya, bhakshya, which comprises of six rasas, which are of either ushna or shita virya, encompasses 20 plus gunas, which is properly taken following all the course in conducts, and also which is properly digested. Such type of consumed material is called ahara. If this ahara establishes the prakriti through doshas in samasthiti and brings the vishama dhatus to their respective abodes, that is samikarana, then it is called hita ahara. If ahara neither stabilizes the samadhatu nor reroots the vishamadhatus, it should be recognized as ahita ahara. With this clarity, let us now understand what is the major contributor to the formation of khavaigunya. Only hita ahara is reason for purusha vriddhi, that is growth and development, while ahita ahara results in vyadhi. This gives the hint that ahita ahara is the first and foremost to contribute to the formation of khavaigunya. Acharya Charaka thus advocates that only with prior examination ahara has to be consumed. What consumed is hita ahara alone has to be made sure. Ahara kalpan nahetun svabhavadin samikshya hitamashniyat dehohi ahara sambhavaha. This hita ahara is the reason for origin of deha. One more factor of utmost importance is agni, needed for the sustenance of deha. Higher to all these, dosha, dhatu and mala are moola for deha. Thus, only hita ahara coupled with sandhukshita agni can bring the best outcome, and hence ahara attains the state of rasayana only when it is hita. In Agrya Prakarana, it is mentioned that yatha agnyabhyavaharo agnisandhukshananam. So, depending on the state of agni, ahara has to be consumed such that it results in agnisandhukshana. But to maintain the state of agni, matra ahara and specially hita ahara consumption matters. Summing up all of the above discussions, only when hita ahara is consumed, agni sandhukshana occurs, and it is not just the jatar agni sandhukshana, it is also dhatvagni and bhutagni sandhukshana. Only when hita ahara is consumed, with the support of sandhukshita agni, proper digestion and metabolism results in. Thus, there is a direct relation between hita ahara and purusha vriddhi, as only those which are rasayana can cause this very particular action. Substantiating hita ahara as rasayana through Sharangadhara's definition. Rasayanas are those dravya which prevents an individual from succumbing to jara, that is early aging, and vyadhi, that is diseases. Or it evades these two presentations altogether. Previously, we confirmed that it is ahita ahara which is vyadhi nimitta. Hence, hita ahara should be vyadhi nimittam na or avyadhi nimittam. Hence, hita ahara must be a rasayana, preventing an individual from all the untoward circumstances. This ends episode 2, establishing the fact that only Sandhukshita Agni can establish a healthy state. In the next episode, let us understand the next phases of Jatharagni Chintana. For more knowledgeable videos, keep watching Ayurchintana. Learn, practice, and live Ayurveda. Thank you.